Hello, and thank you for taking the time to check out this video. This is a part of a series of three videos that demonstrate how you can use your favorite languages other than SAS with the high-performance time series and forecasting framework built into SAS visual forecasting software. We realized that languages like Python and R are seeing rapid adoption, so we created interfaces to SAS Cloud Analytics Services to enable you to invoke SAS data processing from these popular languages. In this video, I'll show you how to invoke SAS visual forecasting functionality from Python and R. In the other two videos in the series, I'll show you how to run and scale Python and R code for time series processing and forecasting in a cloud environment. Let's get started with a quick high-level look at the multi-tiered design of SAS visual forecasting. As this figure shows, when you interact with the Model Studio graphical user interface, your actions are communicated through a REST API to what we call CAS actions, which are units of functionality that run on your CAS servers. CAS is short for SAS's Cloud Analytics Services, which is a distributed in-memory execution infrastructure of SAS VIA. Don't worry if you don't know what REST APIs are. The point I'm trying to get across is that the interface you interact with is decoupled from the logic and algorithms performed by SAS Visual Forecasting. SAS Visual Forecasting is built on SAS VIA. As a result, it is designed to effectively model and forecast time series at a large scale with its highly parallel and distributed architecture. Massively parallel processing within a distributed architecture is one of the key advantages SAS Visual Forecasting offers for large-scale time series forecasting. A lot of work has gone into supporting different programming interfaces to SAS VIA. As a result, if you would rather use your favorite programming language to call SAS visual forecasting actions, you can use interfaces for languages like Python and R to access the same high-performance SAS visual forecasting functionality. Now, a brief note about performance. In this era of big data, where datasets can consist of millions of time series, performance is one of the top selling points for SAS visual forecasting. To generate the chart you see here, we used an 87 gigabyte dataset with 1.5 million time series as input and ran it with an increasing number of processors. We were able to reduce the runtime from about an hour to around 5 minutes just by adding nodes. No changes to the code were necessary. It took over 2 hours to run with our single-threaded infrastructure. Again, I won't go in depth into all the features of visual forecasting. It includes data preparation, diagnostics, modeling, forecasting, and collection of results. This video gives a high-level overview of how you can create models, generate forecasts, and look at results by using either SAS, Python, or R code. Before getting into the demo, let me quickly go over what happens when you run jobs in SAS Visual Forecasting. Again, this is very high level, and there are more in-depth presentations available. I just want to give you a basic understanding so it's not a black box. All jobs you send from your client program are processed on your designated servers. In this depiction, we use a cluster of 4 worker nodes connected to a distributed file system. Now, let's say we have 2 input tables we want to process, each with 7 time series. You create your client script, and it is copied to all the worker nodes. If you're using SAS Visual Forecasting graphical user interface, it creates the scripts for you. SAS VIA automatically distributes the time series among available nodes and runs your script on those inputs in parallel on the available worker machines. Output data tables are written to the distributed file system, which can be a traditional network file system or Hadoop. Okay, now let's start the actual demo. I'll be running 3 different programs, which do pretty much the same thing, but they are written in 3 different languages. The code that is sent to the server is always the same. This is defined via a variable named CMP code in all the demo programs. It uses the automatic time series modeling package to determine the best model for forecasting each time series in the dataset. The dataset we use is the skin product dataset, which is a synthetic dataset consisting of sales information for various skincare products. When we use product key and distribution center as bivariables, it contains 1,337 time series. For this demo, I'll be using SAS as the client and the CAS procedure to call the CAS action that runs the code. You can also use the TS model procedure for this. Here you can see the code that is run. I won't go into the details here in the interest of time. I'll just click run and wait a bit. And there we have our results. You can see that for each time series, the details about the ATSM and ESM models that were tried and which model was selected. The model that is selected is shown here in the selected column. The code also generated this scatter plot showing the actual and predicted results for one of the products. Now let's look at the Python example. I'll just quickly go through this. First, you import the necessary modules and set the configuration variables. Then you create the connection to the CAS server where all the processing will happen. Then you upload your dataset to CAS. You need to let CAS know which action sets you intend to use, and you do this using the load action set call. Then you specify the server code that selects the best model. This is identical to the previous example. Finally, you can submit the action. From there, you can process it however you like. This program tabulates the results using Python print statements and generates a scatter plot of one of the time series actual numbers versus the predicted amounts. Okay, now let's go to the R example. The sequence of steps is pretty much the same as in the Python example. So you load the necessary modules, specify the configuration settings, connect to the CAS server, upload the input data, and load the time data action set. Then you use the same server code as in the SAS and Python client examples, and you run the action. Now you can do whatever you want with the output data. This example does the same thing that the Python example did. It tabulates the results and creates a figure that compares the actual and predicted revenue for one of the time series. The predicted revenue comes from the selected best model. And there you have it. As you've witnessed, you can tap into the power of SAS visual forecasting from multiple programming languages. Please make sure you check out our other videos that show you how to run Python and R code on the CAS servers. And please contact us if you have any questions. Thanks again, and see you next time.